good evening. Yes, I'm sure many of you have heard that we've lost the last male white rhino. He's gone from the planet forever. We have two females, but the luck with them is I don't know all of the logistics of them. Actually, I have not researched it, but we have the two females. The only thing we can do then is presume that there is some of the old dude's sperm and then inseminate, and then there's a birth, and then from the birth, if it's a female, then inseminate again from the father. That's kind of sick, but that would be a way to continue. If it is a male, then take his sperm and inseminate it with his aunt, and put the aunt and his together, and put that into another hippo, another rhino, because chances are at that point the other two are unavailable to be carriers, to carry the birth. So it would have to be put in another type of rhino, and then from there would perhaps be another rhino. So it's yow. I mean, that's that talk about walking through a maze and having a lot of blocks and things just not working. And oh my gosh, yeah, I don't know. They already said the insemination process for one of them would cost $9 million. So they're already putting a big wall. Because that's just the one time. You have to think about the birth and then where it's going from there. You know, so we can also accept it just a write-off, just that he's gone, and the species will be gone when the two girls go, when they leave. So, other news, and I was like, well, gee, this is not real peppy retrograde 2018, is it, of Jupiter? The second thing I had was, when we go into, we're discussing... What? I got in my email today that the northern Atlantic right whale, there are many of them, I thought. Well, no. There was stated 300 to 350. But they have no sightings of any calves this year. None. So it's almost like a complete wipeout. No calves, there's no, you know, it's almost like a complete wipeout of the entire group. So I can't say anything other than that would be. They're one of the largest ones too. They're one of the largest whales that are out there. They're not like the big blue or anything, but yeah, they're a large whale. Anyway, so that's pretty terrible. And then I'm like, well, meanwhile, haunting me, is I saw this video. It was a peta video where they had found, where, you know, they get in there to these laboratories, these experimental laboratories. And there is this woman, and she is taking the teeth out of a dog with no anesthesia on this animal. The dog is whining and crying, and she's pulling his teeth out. And I'm like, well, if that's going on, and this woman is just like, that's her work, that's what she does, I'm like freaking out that she's pulling the teeth out of the dog, and I'm still freaking out. It's on video. The dog is dying. There's no anesthesia, and she is killing the dog. And then I'm like, well, later on they have another dog that's just salivated to death. Probably because of they pulled something out of his teeth, something out of his mouth also. Some experiment company in America, of the United States. So I'm still in shock because this woman, her attitude, the way she was, the way she handled the situation. Oh my gosh. I just can't believe it. Her audacity and her like just would not stop. No heart. There is no heart in these people. And they are walking among us on this planet. These types of animal experimental abusers are walking amongst us. And they freak me out. I don't trust anybody anymore. It's getting to the point like, well, maybe you're the type that pulls the teeth out of dogs without anesthesia. Maybe you're the type that pulls the teeth out of dogs, period. Maybe I don't want to even talk to you. I saw a guy today at the store, and he had two huge, what were they? Kind of like these Andrioniac poodles or something. And I'm like, well, yeah, that normally would be funny, and I would go say hey to hide to the dogs, but no. I am freaked out. I don't know who he is. I don't know what he does for a living. I don't know if he could be a teeth puller also out of those poor dogs. So this goes back to there are so many horrible people on this planet. And now today I talked to a woman and she said proudly that she'd worked at the store for 23 years. And in a way I was like, relief. She is not one. She is not pulling teeth out of dogs. So I had a relief, a loyalty relief, that she'd worked there and nowhere else. I don't know what she did before. She could have pulled teeth out of dogs before. You know what I'm saying? So in a way, I only want to befriend ballet people. People who do the opera. I only want to befriend you because who are the others? Who are these other people? At least if you're in the dance, if you're in the ballet, if you are in on the stage, even if you're a modern constructionist, squirming yourself around through some kind of a tube, you are still not pulling teeth out of the dog. Okay? I know I've said it a lot of times, but if you see that video, it's on peta.org. And it's heart-wrenching and absolutely horrible. And it's like, well, so it's just a ruin, isn't it? It's just a ruin of, hey, I want to be your friend. But what I did notice, when I go back to this woman, what I did notice is her attitude at that moment, the anger that she was, the tap level, I'll call it the tap level of her demeanor was so curt, so coarse, so what do you call it? It's like when, I'm speechless. Yeah, the person, it was so aggressive, and I really mean aggressive. And so I'm like, well, if their person is that aggressive, and I'm freaking out, you know, because I'm like, all this enlightenment, I feel a lot of things. Okay, so I'm like, okay, well, when I'm aggressive, oh my God. And I'm aggressive also, you know, I start to like freak out when this woman, in a way, she is like a what do you call it, a whip to your own aggression level, because she was so gross, she was so disgusting as a human, that I don't ever want to go that direction, be like her, ever emanate a mimic or even have a tonation of my voice similar to that woman. which is very interesting for especially for singers. We don't want to have, you know, certain tonations. And oh my gosh. And then I'm like, well, this is tough, you know, because I'm like living. I'm living with sometimes, you know, difficulty. You know, you live with an elderly person. They don't always get things right away. They want things instant, you know, and so they can rile and rile, and then they can push and push. But I am not drawn into that at all. However, I'm just wondering that rile, the push, and how that ugly person is created, you know. How are these ugly people created, you know? And so I told my dad, I said, don't make me ugly. Don't make me ugly. Don't rile me. Don't push so far. Don't expect so much. I mean, I cook, I clean, I garden for him. You know, hopefully we're gonna have good food growing from the garden. You know, I drive for him. I do a lots of things, but that, you know, the bills and, but at the same time, you know, don't push me. You know? And I'm like, I hate that part of myself as a person that feels that level of, I feel attacked, and so I want to go back on the attack. So you start to feel this attack mechanism. I call it the IP because we're dealing with all the time this Pakistan and Israel. Okay, so I call it that attack. You know, it's like you did this to me, I do that to you. You know, such a tit for tat attack. And so I'm like, well, that's what this woman was doing with this dog, in a way. You know, that's how sick and disgusting she was. You know, she couldn't. She was that horrible that she saw shit, that her attack, her fight was with a dog, you know, a dog that's not doing anything but being held by her in her forces, in her strength, and then having the teeth pulled out with pliers. So, yeah. Anyhoot, when you feel that, when you feel like somebody is egging you in to the tit for tat moments, oh my gosh, back away, because it is so much pushing you closer to that woman. I'm not kidding. Just pushing you into the ugly self of you. You know what I mean? The ugliest part of yourself. Anyway, I know nobody wants to watch me anymore, but gosh dang it, that's rough, you know. It's rough. We lost our little white rhino, but when we're going into the... Yeah, you hear that even tone in your voice, like, oh gosh, I led myself that far. How ugly of me. Retract, you know, let this be like the retrograde mirror. That was wrong. That's not a beautiful I want of myself. Don't ever want that. All right, I know there's probably huge news going on all around the world. My big news is, I don't know, I'm trying to just keep my upper back straight and tall and not slunk. The slunking, I don't know what that is all about. Something in our upper backs, we seem to lose it, even though all those years of dancing. Anyway, I used to say love to you all, but now I'm not so sure. I'm not so sure, because when I think about, you know, what does the penance do for that type of character? I don't have a good answer, because I'm very strict. I don't want that person. I don't want that person, obviously, to own animals. I don't want that person near me. I don't want that person even on the planet. So, yeah, I'm not very good. Remember, they wanted, old days, they wanted those types, certain types of people, like electrocuted to death. I'm with them. And this type of person would do that. I don't want them here. They're just too bad. All right. Well, anyway, that's it. Good night.